The needle room is probably one of the more horrific of the traps that we've had.
Hello, Xavier. I want to play a game.
He was a drug dealer.
The game of offering hope to the desperate for a price.
He has to crawl through the pit of needles to find one key.
It will be like finding a needle in a haystack.
I think Jigsaw says a line like, you will have to crawl through the squalor which you infect others with if you want to survive.
And I'm not going in there, so I try to pick out which one to go in there, so I pick Amanda.
And action!
No! 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 No!
Oh, that needle pit. It was just so much fun. I just loved it.
No, you're going to feel that right at home!
That's the one that really gets to me, because I have a huge needle phobia.
This was something that I think was just a vague notion in everyone's head at the beginning of the movie.
It's one thing for me to write it and say, oh, we're going to put a bunch of needles and it'll be easy and you'll jump in it.
Not that many people had processed it far enough to really understand what was going to be involved here.
You're going to feel right at home in there!
The initial concept where she'd be neck deep in needles wasn't going to work because a person would not actually sink in this needle pit.
It would actually look better to have Shawnee fall a distance down into the pit.
How you like that?
It morphed into this kind of crawling through the needles.
Come on, keep looking for that key.
One of the things we had to do to aid in the stunt was
we had to line the needle pit completely with foam to make it safe.
We had to make the floor padded all around the edges so you can see that this is actually just soft stunt padding.
Not to mention the fact that how do you make needles safe? We took these syringes and we took the needle tips out one at a time. We had a crew of people sitting there day after day pulling needles out.
And our idea was to get people in, probably take 2 or 3 days with 2 people, to pluck the tips of the needles out and replace it with a fiber optic tip. So the first day we realized that we weren't going to get anywhere near enough needles that were plucked and retipped.
Well, we did 20,000 needles and it barely covered the bottom of the pit. Then we got another 40,000 needles. So now we have 40,000 needles. We have an entire team. That's their entire job. They come to work to pull the needles out, to put plastic one in. That's what they do all day.
It took 4 people, 4 days.
Then we have what? 60,000 needles. Not enough. So we ended up, I think the final count's 120,000 needles. And that still is not that deep. We had to fill it full of gunk and styrofoam to make the needles actually rise up.
We decided to add a few buckets of slime to the needle pit to really make it gross. And what that did was actually make the needles slide a little bit more. The needles actually moved around for them nicely and they were able to swim in them a little bit more.
And you could actually move through the syringes rather than walking on top of them. So it really helped us out.
In the end, they were quite gentle to the touch.
We ended up having to bulk it up more because we realized we didn't have enough. So we just ran out and bought another 300 boxes, and we bought the ones that don't have the twist ends. So those are the ones with twist ends that we'd have to take the needle tip out of. These ones didn't, so they just kind of bulked it up. So if you see here, most of these syringes don't have tips in them, so we kind of cheated the look. Then we would take our other syringes that do have the fiber optic tips and just dress those over just on the day, and it just created the more sinister looking needle tip syringe look that we were going for. So this is the end product of all the syringes and all our hard work. It's 4 days of people pulling them out, take the top off, pull the actual syringe piece out of it, then take a fiber optic cable that we had previously painted and cut to the right size and insert it into the hole and then glue it in place. These would bend. It's still a bit of a prick, but it doesn't actually penetrate the skin.
We had applied a coating of shellac and paint to the needles themselves so they looked used, and we even put a layer of blood on top of them so that they looked disgusting altogether.
Do you want to rehearse with Allie while we stick needles in me?
We had to figure out a way to stick syringes into Amanda, and we had to do that in a safe way. We took a real syringe, clipped the end off, and then it's the real metal syringe, but it's in more of a safe mode. Wardrobe came up with the great padding that would slide under her wardrobe that was plastic with a high-density foam over top of it. It went into the foam, hit the back plastic, and just stayed upright. We just had to be really careful that none of these syringes fell into this pit. So it was quite an ordeal to watch these and watch where they went, so to keep her safe, because she was in and out of it all day.
Okay.
I really like the needle gag itself. Not necessarily because of the makeup, but the whole aspect is kind of creepy. And what we did was make these little anchoring plates. We glued these to the skin. And then we covered them with a little acrylic transfer that would cover the whole rig.
Just throwing on a spatter of color just to break up the surface and just sort of add some freckles and spots and help break up the edges. I'm just putting some irritation marks right around where the needles are going in. I'm just doing it with an airbrush, just for a little bit more precision and a nice feathered look.
Once the makeup was on her arm, we would then insert the syringe.
Ew.
We built syringes that were extremely lightweight. The regular syringes would actually bend the skin, would pull the skin a little bit.
As a producer, that's like one of the greatest things. You hire the best special effects guy you can, and you say, I want to see 14 needles sticking out of Shawnee Smith's body. And they go away and do whatever, like voodoo they do, and they come back and they show it to me. And I go, oh, wow, that's really cool.
Which arm is the fake one? Is the right one? It's that one?
Hey, Francois? Yeah. Can I see that in here, please?
We had to build an arm for retracting the needles. We couldn't pull the needle straight out of the arm. The actual pin had to stay on the arm. So we built a silicone arm. It had a very, very slight movement in it just to give it a little bit of life. And this would be for the retraction of the needles.
Let's see it back in frame. Let's just get a position.
Because it gets really, really crazy.
Action!
Bitch! That's enough! That's not nearly enough!
Then we just go back and stick him in and redo it again.
So it turned out quite gruesome.